just gone noon, half past monsoon, on the banks of the River Nile. And here comes the boat, only half a flood, Osman grins a toothless smile. Only just one more to this desolate shore, last boat along the River Nile. Doesn't seem to care, no more wind in his hair, he reaches his last half mile. The oar snaps in his head before he reaches dry land. The sound doesn't dampen his smile. Just pokes it with sand, an oar in his hand. He floats soft down the River Nile. He floats soft down the River Nile. Oh, great Caesar, he was a right tasty geezer. Dance, Cleopatra, dance. Hey Madness fans, been a weird old time, hasn't it, eh? To say the very least. So what I thought was, I've sort of had enough of pop stars' paintings, bread glasses, Pilates. I did that for about half an hour and then pulled me ribs. And then I learned to play the piano and Italian. Ain't been doing nothing. I've been lying on a sun lounger, drinking beer. But hey ho, we just thought we'd like to do something for you. Welcome to our new space. This is a little environment we've got ourselves in Barzo and the London String Group, which is Tina, Fred, and now what are your names? Come on, let's be fair. Richard, Sam, Ruth, and Tina Sparkle. We just thought we'd like to play with a few songs, yeah. Well, there's a Mark II parked on the cobbles of a Chelsea museum out of the shadows. Steps a figure, silver mohair bright, into the moonshine, out into the night. And in the darkness, one stray moonbeam creeps through the curtain on the unmade bed. She stares at the ceiling, just an empty feeling. He starts the Jaguar and drives away. A word, 'cause even breathing can be heard right through the silver screen. They've made inquiries, they'll take it easy, but she won't answer 'cause she's not really there. He throws his gloves out the open window, he lights a cigarette, drives away. Lights a cigarette, drives away.
Yeah, I hope you're all doing all right out there. It's most bizarre, isn't it? And it's most dreary, you know, going through our diaries, working out what gigs we're not doing tonight. And in fact, when we talked about doing this, I rang Tina and I said, have you got anything on next week? And she put the phone down. She thought I was taking the piss. Have we got anything on as musicians? No, we haven't. Anyway, that's not the point. We're here to cheer you up a bit. And I don't know. We've got a couple of plaintive numbers, a couple of new songs, a couple of old ones, goldens and all that. Hope we can entertain you for this evening. And here's a really nice pop hit that we wrote. My girl's mad at me. I didn't want to see the film tonight. I found it hard to say. She thought I'd had enough of her. Why can't she see? She's lovely to me, but I like to stay in and watch TV on my own every now and then. My girl's mad at me. Been on the telephone for an hour. We hardly said a word. I tried and tried, but I could not be heard. Why can't I explain? Why do I feel this pain? 'Cause everything I say, she doesn't understand. She doesn't realize. Takes it all the wrong way. My girl's mad at me. We argued just the other night, and I thought we got it straight. We talked until it was light. I thought we'd agree. I thought we talked it out. Now when I try to speak, she says that I don't care. Says I'm unaware, and now she says I'm weak. Yeah, here's a new song, what I wrote. It's called The Theatre of the Absurd. And I was looking up what it means. And the Theatre of the Absurd was an existential outfit from Paris or somewhere. When all meaning and context has gone out of your life and you can't actually communicate anymore, you just start talking gobbledygook. Anyway, I don't know what that applies to or who in the current government, but you know. The lights go down on some dark theatre in London. Ooh, the coolest comedy. The audience hold their breath, they freeze and dare not look away. Ooh, the coolest comedy. The actors stumble on with masks but no real plot. There are no exit signs and all the doors are locked. And the compere jumps up. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so glad that you heard of the blackest black comedy from the house of the absurd. The black is a black comedy. Orchestras strike up a song that no one's heard of, a storyline that no one knows to sing. But this cabaret must never end. A dozen roses no one sends. At last, the cruelest comedy. The stage is draped in palest, palest bitter blue. And from the wings end, right on cue. The compere jumps up. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so glad that you heard of the blackest, a black comedy from the house of the absurd. Ha ha ha, blackest, a black comedy. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, will you please walk this way for the last and only performance of the cruelest cabaret. Yeah, and I find myself getting slightly fed up of having to apologise about gigs that we can't do, but I know you're as upset as we are. But one thing we're hanging on to for the people who bought tickets for the House of Fun in Minehead, that is still sort of on the cards in November, but we don't know. Hopefully we'll see you there. If not, all the other gigs have been postponed till next year. Again, hopefully, who knows? If not, look for me on a park bench in your nearest park with a can of cider. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. But her mummy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen. Now she walks through her sunken dream to the seat with the clearest view. And she's hooked to the silver screen. But the film is a saddening bore, and she's lived it 10 times or more. She could spit in the eyes of fools as they ask her to go for some sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. We'll take a look at the lawman beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, I wonder if he'll ever know. He's in the best-selling show. Is the life on Mars? Thank you. Ricker's tortured brow, and Mickey Mouse has grown up a cow. Now the workers have struck for fame, 'cause linen's on sale again. See the mice in the million hordes, from our beef to the Norfolk boards. Oh, Britannia is out of bounds, to my mother, my dog, my clowns. But the film is a saddening bore, 'cause I wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be writ again, and they ask you to go for some sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. We'll take a look at the lawman beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if he'll ever know. He's in the best-selling show. Is there life on life on Earth? And here's another really nice pop hit what we wrote. It's raining again, I'm hearing it. Pizza patter down, it's wet in the streets, reflecting the lights and splashing feet. Nowhere to go, oh, and nothing I have to do. It's raining again, I follow the Christmas lights downtown. I'm leaving the flow, people walking all around, round and round. I hear the sound of rain falling in my ears, washing away the weariness like tears. And I can feel my troubles running down, disappearing to the silent sound. Yeah, I'm just walking along, my clothes are soaked right through to the skin. I happen to doubt this is what life is all about. The sun and the rain, they walk with me, they fill my heart again. I hear the rain falling in my ears, washing away the weariness like tears. And I can feel my troubles running down, disappearing to the silent sound. The sound. In the clouds reveals a blue sky, 'cause I've been feeling so low,
low.
But everything is on my side. The sun and the rain, they walk with me, they fill my heart again. I hear the rain falling in my ears, washing away the weariness like tears. And I can feel my troubles running down, disappearing to the silence. I feel the rain falling on my face, and I can say there is no better place. Standing up in
falling down. In the summer train I could almost drown. And do 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 do.
Okay, this song is about the dire straits over the pond at the moment. No, not really at the moment. It's a song about our cousins in America, yeah. Leaders of the world. And where they're leading us, who knows?
The year was 1963. The last one for Kennedy. In 69, the Lorraine Motel on the balcony where the doctor fell from a single shell. A last shot at democracy, shining city on the hill, land of the free. 17 agencies looking out for thee, the NSA and Homeland Security. A shot rang out, the sound of gunfire echoes across the mall. The future sucked into a dark black hole. Short-sighted small minds clamor for control. But there's no dream no more. Psyops are now running the school, and the money trickles upwards evermore. You'd almost think it was 1984. These are the streets I used to walk on the summer night, sit out and talk. And that's the house where I used to live. I remember what I would give. This is the town I won't forget. And after anger, there's nothing left. Walking now around and round, familiar sights are open ground. But being here again, I can recall forgotten moments, the rise and fall. We used to live where children play. They leave their homes a mile away to come and stand in trees and grass. Where we once walked, the memories last. But being here again, I can recall forgotten moments, the rise and fall. The sun shines east, the sun shines west, but I know where the sun shines best. Casey Street in the afternoon. Once again, it's over too soon. But being here again, I can recall
forgotten moments, the rising fall, being here again, I can recall. Forgotten moments, the rising fall. Tell you some anecdotes of my lockdown period, yeah. Anyway, I drank a lot of beer, but no, I'll tell you what did happen. Now I come to remember. My daughter told me, I was waiting for these weights to arrive. I ordered these weights on Amazon. Do you know what you can get? You can order things online and all that. Anyway, I got these, and I thought I'd get these ones that you can fill with water at different weights, you know, so you can sort of build up without having to have a whole set of the flipping things, right? Anyway, they didn't arrive for 2 weeks. And I spoke to my daughter, Scarlett. I said, don't worry about all that, Dad. There's this online thing, and you can just use things that are already in your house as weights. She said, for instance, right, she sent a short film of herself doing leg exercises with baked bean tins down her socks. And you can do, and I can't remember, rucksacks for the books. Do you know about this, Tina? You're a friend of my daughter's. Anyway, so I got into it. So I found a couple of paint tins in the garage. And I found an old chair leg. And I thought, well, that's it, exactly. Do you know what I mean? So, I mean, it may have been a couple of gin and tonics into the evening when I burst into the living room telling my wife, Anne, got it sorted in my underpants. And I lifted up this quite heavy couple of paint tins and I was going like that. And then one fell off and exploded all over the living room, followed by the other one, which exploded all over the sofa. And how we laughed. When you're squashed together in claustrophobic facsimile. It was a bit of a difficult moment, yeah. Father wears his Sunday best. Mother's tired, she needs a rest. The kids are playing up downstairs. Sister's saying in her sleep. Brother's got a day to keep, he can't hang around. Our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our... Well, our house, it has a crowd. There's always something happening and it's usually quite loud. And our mum, she's so house proud. Nothing ever slows her down and this is not allowed. Our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our... Oh, father gets up late for work. Mother has to iron his shirt. Then she sends the kids to school. Sees them off with a small kiss. She's the one they're going to miss in lots of ways. Socially distant, obviously. Of our street, our house, in the middle of our... I don't remember where we were then, when everything was true and when we would have such a very good time, such a fine time, and such a happy time. And I remember how it very simply was a day away, then we'd say nothing would come between us, two dreamers. And father wears his Sunday best. Mother's tired, she needs a rest. The kids are playing up downstairs. Sister's sighing in her sleep. Brother's got a date to keep. She can't hang around our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle of our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle of our house was our castle and our keeping. Our house in the middle of our house. Yeah, that was where we used to sleep. In our house in the middle of our street. Well, thank you so much for watching. As you can see, we've been very delicately 2 metres apart, and you can get back and all sunshine. And we'll see you again soon. I never thought I'd miss you. Well, half as much as I do. And I never thought I'd feel this way, the way I feel about you. Soon as I wake up every night, every day, I know that it's you I need to take the blues away.
Why, oh yeah.
It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. There's nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best. Well, how can it be that we can say so much without words? Well, bless you and bless me. Bless the bees and the birds. I've got to be near you every night, every day. I couldn't be happy any other way. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. Cause there's nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. All you need is love. It must be love, love, 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 love. There's nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best. Sending out the love.